Good morning, friends, and welcome once again to this wonderful session of physics today. So today, dear friends, we are going to talk about the concept of the pressure exerted by the gas on the walls of the container in which it is kept. And this article is in the unit of kinetic theory of gases. This is in the unit of kinetic theory of gases. And here what we are going to discuss is, we are going to discuss about the pressure of gas on the walls of container. Now, dear friends, as you all know that whenever we are putting a gas in the closed vessel, it will be moving in the random direction and it will continuously keep on colliding against the wall of the container. It will continuously keep on colliding with the wall of the container and exert a force or the pressure on it. Now, if suppose we have a cuboidal vessel, let us take a cuboidal vessel of, let us say, length L, breadth B, and the depth as D, which is containing n number of gas molecules. So this is our y-axis, this is our x-axis, sorry, this is y and this is our z-axis, and this is the origin. So if I complete this cuboid in this fashion, so this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E, this is G, this is, let us say, H. And that is O. Now, dear friends, if I consider one molecule of gas, which is here, it is, and let me consider its movement along x-axis, along x-axis, that means OX it is moving. So obviously, it will be having a momentum of mvx. It will be moving along OX and it will hit the wall of the container, which is ABHG, with a momentum which is mvx. Now, because we are considering the gas molecule to be perfectly elastic, so its collision with the wall will also be a perfectly elastic collision. It means this molecule will hit the wall and rebound back with the same momentum. It will rebound back with the same momentum. But because the direction has changed, so I will be writing this as minus mvx. It means this is the initial momentum of the particle going to hit the wall, and this is the final momentum of the particle which has rebounded back. Now, if I talk about the change in momentum along x-axis, so obviously you know delta px will be equal to final momentum minus the initial momentum. Now, final momentum is minus mvx and the initial momentum is plus mvx. So what I get, my delta px is equal to minus 2mvx. I hope this point is clear to you. So this is the change in momentum which is coming in case of one particle. Now we want to find out, because there is not only one particle, there will be many particles. There will be many particles. So I want to find that how much momentum will be there in change in a particular time of delta t. यानी डेल्टा टी टाइम में कितना चेंज इन मोमेंटम होता है उन पार्टिकल्स के लिए. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट कि हाउ मेनी पार्टिकल्स आर देयर विच आर हिटिंग द वॉल ऑफ द कंटेनर विच इज ए बी एच जी इन डेल्टा टी. यानी सबसे पहले तो हम ये पता लगाएंगे कि डेल्टा टी टाइम में ए बी एच जी को हिट करने वाले कितने पार्टिकल्स हैं, क्योंकि एक पार्टिकल का चेंज इन मोमेंटम हमें पता है. तो जितने पार्टिकल हिट करेंगे उनका मोमेंटम हम निकाल लेंगे. राइट, नाउ वी नो दैट इन टाइम डेल्टा टी ऑल दोज पार्टिकल्स which are enclosed in this cylindrically assumed volume, which are enclosed in this cylindrically volume, will hit the wall. मान लीजिए कि इस cylindrical volume में जो हमारे total gas molecules है, let small n be the number of molecules per unit volume. नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम को हमने स्मॉल एन मान लिया. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी मॉलिक्यूल्स आर देयर इन दिस वॉल्यूम. सो व्हाट आई विल राइट, वॉल्यूम ऑफ सिलेंडर, यू नो व्हाट इज द लेंथ, लेंथ इज this one, what is called Vx into delta T. This is the length, Vx into delta T. And what is the area? This is the area A. So length into area, that will give you volume. So this is the volume. So itni volume mein, how many number of particles will be there? So what is this? This is n. This is n. So n is equal to this, and what will be n? Sorry, capital N. That is equal to n into v. Capital N is equal to n into v. And what is v? This is v. So what is the number of particles? That is n into Vx into delta T into A. This is the, ये क्या हुआ? These are the number of particles which are hitting the wall of the container A, B, H, G in the volume of this cylinder. इतने molecules, अब एक मॉलिक्यूल की जो चेंज इन काइनेटिक, चेंज इन मोमेंटम है, दैट इज दिस. तो व्हाट आई विल राइट, तो आई विल राइट टोटल चेंज इन मोमेंटम, टोटल चेंज इन मोमेंटम विल बी इक्वल टू माइनस टू एम वी एक्स इनटू एन वी एक्स delta T into A. It means it will be minus 2 m n v x square into delta T A. So what is this? This is the total change in momentum. लेकिन ये तब possible होगा अगर सारे particle एक ही डायरेक्शन में जा रहे होंगे तो, along x axis. But because the particles are in random motion, so there will be half of the particles which are moving towards the wall and half of the particle which are coming away from the wall. See, because there is a random motion and when you start observation, so ये तो है नहीं कि immediately start होगा. तो when you start taking observation, तो आपको क्या लगेगा कि some are going like this, some are coming back. So on an average, there will be only half of the molecules which will be hitting the wall out of these molecules. तो इतना momentum नहीं होगा, change in momentum will be half. तो यहाँ क्या लिखा जाएगा? कि on an average, there will be half molecules. So on an average, there will be half molecules hitting the surface. So delta px will be equal to. So delta px will be equal to m into n into vx square into delta p into a. Now this is the change in momentum. Now we know, देखिए ये होगा change in momentum. अब एक molecule wall पर कितनी force लगा रहा है, पहले force निकालेंगे, then we will move on to the pressure. याद रखना हमारा आर्टिकल है कितना प्रेशर आएगा. अभी हमने मोमेंटम की बात की है. मोमेंटम से हम फोर्स निकालेंगे, फिर फोर्स से हम प्रेशर निकालेंगे. देखिए वी नो दैट व्हाट इज फोर्स. फोर्स इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन मोमेंटम पर यूनिट टाइम. फोर्स इज चेंज इन मोमेंटम पर यूनिट टाइम. तो व्हाट इज द चेंज इन मोमेंटम, दैट मींस डेल्टा पी एक्स, एंड व्हाट इज द टाइम, दैट इज डेल्टा टी. एनी डाउट? सो दैट इज द चेंज इन मोमेंटम ओवर टाइम. तो व्हाट इज डेल्टा पी एक्स, यू हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड. सो व्हाट विल बी द फोर्स अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस, डेल्टा टी एंड डेल्टा टी विल कैंसिल. So I will be getting m n vx square, sorry, I forgot minus. So minus will be also there. So minus m n vx square into a. Now this is the force which is exerted by the molecules on the wall of the container. This is the force which is exerted by the molecules on the wall of the container. अब हालांकि assumptions पे ही सारा physics है. अब यहां जब हमने vx ले लिया, you know what is vx, that is the velocity of the particles along x axis. But when I write Vx, मैंने एक चीज और मान ली यहां पर कि जितने भी ये n particles हैं, sorry capital N, जितने भी ये capital N particles हैं, they all are also moving with the same velocity v. But in reality it is not possible. In reality it is not possible that all the particles will be moving towards the wall or away from the wall with the same velocity. So velocity will keep on changing. That means different particles will have different velocities. So in that case, what we will do, we will consider the mean velocity. We will consider the mean velocity. And just what we will do, we will put a bar over here. So you have to just remember, we are taking mean velocity of the particles which are moving towards the wall or coming back from the wall. Clear? Now, we know that simple physics, we know that what is pressure. Because we have to find the pressure. What is the pressure? Pressure basically is the force per unit area. What is the force? upon area. So area and area will cancel. So what is the pressure now? So pressure is equal to minus m into Vx and square. Vx and square. Now this is the pressure exerted by the wall, sorry, by the particles on the wall. Now according to the Newton's third law of motion, what will be the force exerted by the wall on the particles? ये तो फोर्स हो गई जो वॉल ने पार्टिकल्स पे लगाई. पार्टिकल्स भी तो फोर्स लगाएंगे. दैट विल बी सेम इन मैग्नीट्यूड बट डिफरेंट इन डायरेक्शन. बट डिफरेंट इन डायरेक्शन. सो द प्रेशर नाउ विल चेंज फ्रॉम माइनस टू प्लस, क्योंकि हमने फोर्स को क्या ले लिया है, प्लस. फोर्स को क्या ले लिया हम यहां पर, प्लस. ये क्यू प्लस ही है, समझ में आ गया. सो व्हेन दिस इज प्लस, दिस विल आल्सो बिकम प्लस. सो दिस इज द प्रेशर. नाउ दिस इज द प्रेशर अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस, बट देयर विल बी पार्टिकल्स विच विल बी मूविंग अलोंग वाई एक्सिस आल्सो. देयर विल बी पार्टिकल्स विच विल बी मूविंग अलोंग जेड एक्सिस आल्सो. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू टेक द एवरेज ऑफ ऑल द पार्टिकल्स. सो फाइनली व्हाट वी विल राइट, we know that what will be P. Now Px will be equal to Py, will be equal to Pz, will be equal to P. So when I take all those things, so finally what I will be getting P as 1 by 3 M into N Vx and square. So this is your kinetic theory of gas and pressure exerted by the gas on the wall of the container. This is what is P. So P is equal to 1 by 3 M N V square. Now this X will disappear. Now this X will disappear. So average velocity we have considered. So V square will be equal to Vx square plus Vy square plus Vz square. And that is the mean value of velocity, mean square velocity. So P is equal to 1 by 3 rho into V square. अब आपको पता है ना कि M into N क्या होता है. What is M into N? That is rho. That is rho. So M into N is rho. Rho means density. Rho means density. So P is equal to 1 by 3 rho into V square. So till next time, keep it up to here. And tomorrow, or you can say in our next lecture, we will be talking about the derivation of the various gas laws on the basis of same kinetic theory of gas. Gas laws we have already discussed, their statements, their concepts. Boyle's law we know, Charles' law we know, Gay-Lussac's law we know. But now we are going to prove them on the basis of kinetic theory of gas. And this article, my dear friends, will be taken up in the next class. So till that time, have a safe day, have a wonderful day, and keep doing good work, and all the very best. Thank you very much.